Just because you cannot relate that a solanum colli inermi herbaceo follis pinnatus incisus is a simple tomato plant, Linnaeus put some order to the chaos of scientifically naming life forms. These names are important because they allow people throughout the world to communicate unambiguously about animal species or plant species. This works because there are a set of international rules about how to name animals or plants, and zoologists and botanists try to avoid naming the same thing twice. Although this does sometimes happen, the rules are simple. Every recognized species on Earth, at least in theory, is given a two-part scientific name. So this system is called binomial nomenclature. Start the genus name with a capital letter and the species name with a small letter, and you have a good start. Make it a little bit more fancy by underlining it if you write it out, or type it out in italics to indicate a Latin origin. And if you really get into the small details, you'll observe that the first name, which is the genus, is usually a noun, whereas the second name, the species name, is an adjective, like sapiens in Homo sapiens or Leo in Panthera leo. The scientific name of the organism is generally followed by the name of the person or the author who first described the species. Linnaeus authored Homo sapiens in 1758. An organism which deviates from normal standards may be discovered, or a species may be transferred to another genus. In that case, what do you do? The first author's name is given in brackets like this. Say you are naming a species and you want to name it after your parents. One thing you should remember, that it's if it's after dad. That is, if it's a male, the name ends in I. Or if it's after mom or female, the name ends in AE. Like the spider Aposticus Angelina Jolie, which is named after Angelina Jolie. Or the spider Aposticus Barack Obama, which was named after Barack Obama. Bill Gates has a fly to his credit too, the Erysthalis gatesi. So what's the conclusion? Being rich and famous pays. You get a species named after yourself. If not famous, you have some names that are super amazing, like Spongiforma squarepantsi. What's the story? In 2010, a new species of mushroom found in Malaysia surprised scientists with its spongy appearance so much that they just couldn't help themselves and named it this way. And I'll give you one more delightful one. Parastratiosphecomyoidis, which doesn't really seem to mean anything. But it's significant because at 42 characters, this small Indian fly has the longest name of any species. Oddly, binomial nomenclature permits animals to have the same genus and species name, but not plants. Don't believe me? Look at every plant name ever. The ones that approach duplication fall just short. Ziziphus, Ziziphus. Note the I and the Y, okay? Animals, you got plenty. You know any of them? Gorilla, gorilla. Bison, bison. Chinchilla, chinchilla. Iguana, iguana. Vulpes, vulpes. These are called tautonyms.